Night with David Letterman 10 whole times, which is pretty good. That's not too shabby. He's won his, or he's had his own HBO special. I guess he's won his own HBO special as well. He's been nominated for an American Comedy Award, and now he's here on The Inside Word with us. Oh, we also want to point out he has a comedy album. Actually, it's a CD called Relentless, which basically describes your act. Wouldn't you say?
Definitely my touring schedule.
270-something days?
Yeah.
And that's a slow year for you.
That was a slow year. Last year it was that. The year before it was like 300.
That's, what do you do? You just hang out at Howard Johnson's all your life? Is that basically what you do?
Yeah, it's hard to have a relationship with that kind of schedule, I'll tell you that. It's going to take a very special woman, you know, or a bunch of average ones.
Well, we have a number at the end of the show. We'll try and hook you
okay,
up.
Okay, cool.
Like as well. Now, you had an album called Dangerous, and right. Michael Jackson came out with an album called Dangerous. Did it confuse people when they went to buy the record? Or?
Hopefully, but I think if you look at Michael Jackson and myself, who is more dangerous, really?
That's true.
Yeah.
And
all due respect to Mike, but seriously.
And Bad, remember you had Bad? I don't get that. Now, how do you feel about the fact you have a new album called Relentless, and Madonna's new album is now going to be called Relentless? I mean, is that going to cause problems for you? Or?
I'm hoping. Something. I need something.
No, we're just screwing around. It's not really. She's not really calling her out.
Oh, Relentless. Okay.
It's a good idea, though. Maybe she'll do it just to, help the sales. I don't know.
Yeah, that would be great. I do a whole Coke bottle, water bottle bit in there. Yeah.
Now, what he's referring to, in case you didn't see Truth or Dare, is that scene where she has a water bottle in.
And she's relentless.
And she's very relentless with that sucker, I can tell you that right now. You were doing a comedy at the age of 13.
Right.
Right?
Right.
What was your material then? Because your stuff, on here it says parental advisory, explicit lyrics. Were you telling what kind of jokes when you were 13?
Well, when I was 13 years old, I was really influenced by Woody Allen, and I would do material like him. Just to get into, be able to perform. And I would do material like that. You know, I remember the first joke I wrote, in fact, was about my girlfriend leaving me because I got sexy with her, you know, and I said I blew into her ear and her head expanded and she floated away. It was like that, you know, cute. And that lasted a little while before I found me. Relentless, dangerous.
That's a relentless, dangerous kind of thing. And you also, when you would go off to the clubs, you would sneak out of the windows because your parents disapproved?
Oh, sure. Yeah, well, I was 15 years old, and the idea of going to a nightclub downtown on a school night, they didn't want to sign that note. Please let Bill go to the nightclub and hang with nefarious characters. Thanks, Dad. But, yeah, I would, I'd go up to do homework, right? And then I'd go down, out the window, down the, over the garage, down the gutter, and my friend would be out in the back with a car, and we'd go downtown. It's getting back in, that was a little hairy.
Did they ever catch her?
Never did. They still to this day insist that that didn't happen. But they're in major denial.
Are they?
I mean, yeah, I have reviews from, school nights. Look, Dad, look. This is a school night. There's my review. No, you never left this house.
You never did that. You know, I did the same thing when I was a kid. I think everybody snuck out of the house. And all parents...
Did you get reviewed for it?
No, I was lucky I didn't get reviewed, except it's the first time I've ever admitted it, and I'll probably get a phone call when
right.
I get home.
Well, I did that, too, on Dennis Miller's show, when I said that story, and my parents were just, you didn't do that, did you? Yes.
Yes, I really, really did. Well, now, we just found out today, as a matter of fact, that that Tipper Gore could become... The, what do you call the vice president's wife? The second lady? I don't know. Tipper Gore doesn't really like, lyrics that are suggestive or racy or whatever. And you've got some words on here that, that they require parental advisory or bits and everything.
Right.
Do you think you're going to offend the possible new second lady?
I hope to offend her horribly. The actual sticker that goes on there, I wrote the sticker that goes on there. It's not that one. The one that's actually on the album is... Warning, this album contains everything your parents hate, the government fears, and the church preaches against. Enjoy, Bill Hicks. So, I mean, I'm not hiding this, you know. I'm swinging from the hip on this.
You're proud of this.
Definitely, definitely. You know, I don't understand that whole onus of what is pornographic or what's for people to hear or not to hear. It's sort of like freedom of speech.
Exactly.
Okay, yeah, all right.
Just a kind of
some American concept. I don't know what it is.
They wrote this page a couple of years ago.
Right. So that's what the material is on there. Obviously, the bits on there are direct reactions to certain conservative or fundamentally correct people.
Speaking of somebody who is somewhat conservative, H. Ross Perot, you're from Texas.
Right.
He's from Texas. What do you think of Perot and the rest of the people we have a choice to elect in November?
Well, I know one thing for sure. As far as November, America's going to lose. Whatever the choice.
You know, I've got to go along with you there.
Yeah.
It makes you not want to vote.
Perot, you know, I mean, people are desperate, and he's a little demagogue, and I'll solve all your problems. I'll do it. There ain't no problem I can't pay for. Nuh-uh. Yeah, okay. I believe him. I wouldn't vote for him if he paid my rent, all right?
And he could probably afford to do that, right? All of our rents.
I don't know. I just moved here. I got a pretty snazzy place.
Well, we'll talk about
billion a month. I'm not bragging.
You're not too bragging. We'll talk about your snazzy new place and the CD when we come back to Inside Word. Don't go away. We are visiting with comedian Bill Hicks, who has this new album. It's actually a CD called Relentless. You know, one thing that kind of struck us here, why have a comedy album on a CD? Is it better sound quality? I was just...
As opposed to what, an album?
I guess cassettes are an album.
Oh, it's on cassette as well.
Oh, it is? Okay.
And no one makes albums anymore. So we thought, yeah.
Is it totally digital, so it's better words or something?
Oh, definitely. You can hear every syllable. It's going to make Tipper just gray.
I cranked it this morning. I really
She's going to go, I recommend y'all listen to Ozzy Osbourne, not this album. Got to be flexible.
Speaking of flexible, you are in a town that doesn't really like smokers. And I understand you're quite an avid smoker. You don't seem to be the type of person to really tolerate somebody going, excuse me, would you put that out? Do you ever hit anybody? How are you dealing with it?
I put the cigarette out in their eye. I know it's not right. I know it. They should put that on the warning. Warning, this could cause blindness. What? But I'm trying to quit, you know, and people keep recommending that patch, you know, the patch.
Yeah,
but unless I wear it over my mouth, you know, I don't see it work. It's the only way it'll work.
It's just not the way to go.
But it's horrible here, you know. You actually go to a nightclub here, and I'm like, can I see an ashtray, please? You know, and they're like, try the museum. Wow, you guys really got a grip on this here. The display of the last smoker.
They have statues. This is a non-smoking building. Do they try and grab
Yeah, well, not anymore. Sorry. Bill, could you walk out in the alleyway? And, yeah, right.
Yeah, Henry McClure, who used to be with our staff, God rest his soul, is dead now, and I'm sorry that you had to beat him up like that, but he tried. It was
Man,
his job.
L.A. has too many of these little trends. You know, this whole inner child thing, that's... Cut it out. It's not funny anymore. You found your inner child? Yeah, I found a picture of him on a milk carton. Go away. Do me a favor. Get in touch with your outer adult. You know what make your inner child real happy? Get him his own apartment.
Thank you, Bill Hicks. Pick up his album. It's called Relentless. On our next Inside Word, George Thorogood is going to be here, and we're also going to talk more about Princess Diana, a portion of that interview that we didn't get a chance to show you. See you later.